Hello everyone, this is Manabu Tsukada from the University of Tokyo. Today, my presentation is titled Misbehavior Detection Using Collective Perception Message Under Privacy Considerations. In this talk, first I will talk about security and privacy in cooperative intelligent transportation systems. To protect a basic vehicle-to-vehicle message, misbehavior detection is critical against attacking the message from the inside system. On the other hand, pseudonym ID, which have been introduced to protect privacy from tracking, make it challenging to perform misbehavior detection. In this study, we improve the performance of misbehavior detection using observation data of other vehicles. In cooperative ITS, DEVA message has been standardized and DEVA message are under discussion for standardization. DEVA is the beginning of awareness, where the main objective is to share the information that vehicles have. ETSI, European Telecommunications Standards Institute, standardized cooperative awareness message, CAM, to share the location of the vehicle, and a database called Local Dynamic Map, LDM, to store the information obtained from these messages. If these messages are tampered with, it can lead to a severe accident. Regarding the data messages, an effort is underway to standardize message for sharing sensor information. This message is called Collective Perception Message, CPM. Security is essential in cooperative ITS. Public key infrastructure is introduced to authenticate nodes and messages. However, PKI cannot detect and deal with attacks from inside the system. For example, the attackers may provoke emergency braking by sending false location information to the space between vehicles. Therefore, to detect an attack from an authenticated node and reduce the damage caused by the attack, misbehavior detection in BTX communication has been actively developed. In addition, because CAM deal with mobility data, there is a possibility that users' privacy may be violated by tracking vehicles. Considering this, study has been conducted to ensure the anonymity of cooperative ITS participants by using the short-term identifier known as pseudonym ID as the source identifier. In this study, we assume pseudonym IDs and improve the performance of misbehavior detection through the data verification of CAM using CPM. The first issue is adaptation to the pseudonym IDs. We need to eliminate attack messages while preserving privacy. Considering pseudonym IDs, it is impossible to identify a particular vehicle by making individual nodes resolve pseudonym globally. Therefore, it is necessary to have a misbehavior detection method that resolves the pseudonym ID locally. The second issue is performance improvement of misbehavior detection. This study aims to reduce the probability of misdetecting a valid message as an attack message while maintaining a successful detection of attack as an attack. Next, we would like to discuss related work on misbehavior detection against location tampering. In the literature, researchers proposed wireless signal-based geolocation verification method. In reference 1, severe attacks are detected by analyzing the distribution of wireless signal and verifying whether the location information in the message is correct. The second reference proposed an algorithm using the strength of the wireless signal to determine the location of a target without depending on whether it has the information on effective isotropic radiated power. Since these schemes do not depend on node identifier, it works under a pseudonym environment. Other work employs recursive Bayesian estimation for misbehavior detection. In the study by the third reference, the position of the message sender is estimated using a combination of angle of arrival and Doppler velocity measurement of the received signal as input to the extended Kalman filter. The last reference also considers the pseudonym and determines whether there is a plausible Kalman filter state among the several Kalman filter states of the vehicle to be detected. All of the above studies evaluated only CAM or their own messages that dealt only with position and velocity, and none of them dealt with CPM as far as we know. Next, let's talk about the proposed method. The left figure shows the count verification process. The lower part represents the physical world and lower part is the LDM in the central blue vehicle. The blue vehicle knows the real-time position of the other vehicle by receiving counts. The black arrows on the LDM show the accepted counts. When adding these received counts to the LDM, we performed behavior detection to accept or reject the count. The Kalman filter is an efficient and well-known solution to estimate time-varying quantities from discrete error-prone observations such as tracking object. We use Kalman filter to estimate the future motion of the vehicle, and we have used it as the basis for the mobility verification. As shown in the right figure, the acceleration is used as input to the Kalman filter. The output is the estimated position and velocity calculated from the time difference from the previous state. These results are compared with the position and velocity contained in the received CAM and CPM. If the deviation is acceptable, the message is accepted. The system accepts the CAMs from surrounding vehicles that have already been accepted. When the blue vehicle receives a CAM from an unknown ID, there are two valid cases. The first one is a reception from the changed pseudonym ID of the known vehicle, and the second one is a reception from a new vehicle. In the first case, when the pseudonym is changed, the received vehicle holds the Kalman filter associated with the vehicle ID before change. Therefore, if all the Kalman filters in the list are compared with the received CAM, the output of the Kalman filter corresponding to the vehicle ID before the pseudonym change will be the closest value. If the value is plausible, it can be detected as a change in the pseudonym ID. For the second case, because new vehicles often appear from outside of radio communication range, we define the margin area, which is calculated by maximum communication range, Rmax, and margin distance, dmargin. Moreover, we consider the CAM transmitted from this area as new valid vehicle. Also, if a matching vehicle can be observed in the vehicle's sensor, it is treated as a new valid vehicle. Unfortunately, new vehicles appeared outside the margin area and sensing area cannot be considered as new valid vehicles as illustrated by vehicle C. Therefore, regardless of whether they are valid or attack message, all such cases will be rejected. To solve this problem, we employ the sensing capability of the surrounding vehicle using CPM. To expand the area of new vehicle that can be verified, the CPM information is used to generate a new Kalman filter to track a new vehicle more efficiently. However, the perceived object of the CPM used for Kalman filter generation only when the CPM is trustworthy. Therefore, the source information of the CPM should have a verification process same as the CAM verification. Also, we verify whether the perceived object is within the sensor range of the source vehicle. Thus, even if the attacker tampered with the perceived object of the CPM, we can limit the range of inference. Figure shows the flowchart of the proposed method. First, it checks whether this CAM is from a known vehicle. If the Kalman filter corresponding to the returned ID exists, it uses the acceleration as the input of the Kalman filter for verification. After that, we accept the CAM if the position and velocity does not deviate from the Kalman filter's output. Then, if the Kalman filter corresponding to the returned ID does not exist, it checks whether the pseudonym ID has changed. Consequently, it verify the CAM using the output of all the Kalman filters in the list and select the smallest difference. If the value is within the threshold, it updates the state and ID of the corresponding Kalman filter and accepts the CAM. If none of this case holds, we check if the vehicle newly appears. First, it evaluates whether the location information is within the margin area or whether a sensor detects it. If any of these is true, it accepts the CAM and generates a new Kalman filter. Otherwise, the CAM is rejected. In the case of CAM, the verification process is terminated here. If retrieved message is a CPM, we perform the same verification as CAM to check the sender information of the CPM. If the source information of CPM is accepted, the next step is verify the information of the object perceived by the source vehicle. It evaluates the CPM using all the Kalman filters in the list. Supposing there is no Kalman filter corresponding to the perceived object information, a new Kalman filter is generated as a new vehicle after verifying whether it is within the sensor range of the CPM sender vehicle. The architecture of the simulation is shown in the left figure. In this study, we use SMO as an urban traffic simulator and Omnet++ as a network simulator. In addition, we use Bains as a V2X communication framework and Vanessa as an ITS protocol implementation. SVMD provides a various function to simulate the misbehavior detection mechanism. Regarding the implementation of Kalman filter, we use the module provided by F2MD. In addition, considering the sensor function in the vehicle, we use the module provided by Artery. We newly implemented the CP service module according to the flow in the HC technical specification. The table shows the main simulation parameters. All vehicle nodes can send and receive both CAM and CPM messages. The two sensors mounted on the vehicle were evaluated. A sensor with 60 degrees of view in a range of 80 meters in front and a 360 degree sensor with a radius of 80 meters. To simulate the traffic scenario in urban traffic environment, we use the Luxembourg small traffic last scenario, which reflects the realistic mobility patterns in Luxembourg, and its reduced version, the last mini scenario. The last scenario is a traffic scenario characterized by a large amount of traffic on the expressway. In contrast, the last mini scenario is a traffic scenario with only normal roads, not including the expressway. This study assumes that an attacker falsifies the location information, latitude and longitude contained in the basic container in the CAM. Considering our simulation, a node becomes an attacker with a probability of 10% of all the vehicle nodes loaded in SMO. The attacker randomly adds or subtracts 30% of the CAM it sent, corresponding to 3 meter to 40 meter. Next is the simulation result. The figures show the simulation result for the true and false positive rate in the last scenario, and the table is a summary of the figures. The table shows that the false positive rate improved by about 6 percentage points on the average for both the front and 360 degree sensor when using the proposed method. At the same time, it also keeps the true positive rate at the same level as the CAM-only method. This result shows that utilizing CPM is more effective than upgrading the vehicle sensor from front sensor to 360 degree sensors. This is the result of the last mini scenario. The table shows that the proposed method improves the false positive rate by 14 percentage points on average, regardless of the type of sensor. Furthermore, the best case shows 15.6 and 50.7 percentage point improvement considering the front and 360 degree sensor respectively. Because the last mini scenario has a higher density of the vehicle than the last scenario, the Kalman filter generated by the CPM contributes to the performance of validation, whereas the proposed method improves the false positive rate. It also keeps the true positive rate at the same level as shown in the figures. In conclusion, security and privacy are essential in cooperative ideas. We propose a misbehavior detection method that utilizes sensor information of the surrounding vehicles by incorporating CPM into the detection process with a structure that can handle pseudonym ID. The proposed method improves the false positive rate, which misidentifies a valid message as an attack message, while maintaining the level of true positive rate, which correctly detects an attack message. In our future work, the Kalman filter used in this study is suitable for verifying consistency in dynamic system change. However, it does not detect a quantitative offset. In this study, attacks that add quantitative offset to the original data are out of scope. Regarding the CPM data falsification, we set a limit range of the sensor to minimize the effect in this study. It is necessary to measure the effect and to take a countermeasure against the falsification of the CPM data. This is the end of the talk. Thank you.